Do you know the components of a violin? Here I would like to explain you the main components of a violin. This information may be helpful to better understand some other videos of my channel. Hi, welcome to my channel Music and Science. With this video, I would like to present a video about the construction of a violin. I will go into details regarding specific components of a violin. Furthermore, I would like to recommend you to view similar videos, for example, about violin making in Germany. And I also have an interesting video focusing on the issue about why the sun plays cool music. Before I start, I would like to give you some technical information. Below you can see a detailed video description. And from time to time on the upper right part, information cards can appear. The initial idea of this video was an interesting observation when I invited some guests to my home. I cooked and we had interesting talks, and then we came to the violins because I'm playing violin. And I explained them some interesting details about the construction of a violin, history of violin making, and also some interesting connection to the science. I was totally surprised that these guests didn't know some specific details. And this was the idea of this video, as I'm explaining as follows. Okay, let's start with the first part of my video about the construction of a violin. I'll come a bit closer to the camera so that you can see more the details. Here this part is the head of the violin. It's like a body. It has a head, a neck. This is the neck. And here is the main body. Here is the waist. And starting with the head, the most interesting part of the head is the scroll. The scroll, as here, this is scroll. Here you can see from the side the scroll. You can assess the quality of a violin making about the scroll, how the scroll is produced. And these black parts, these are the so-called tuning pegs. Here, the tuning pegs. And this is the peg box, and here we have the neck and the fingerboard, and here we have the main body of the violin. Here is the upper boat and is a lower boat, and in between we have the so-called waist. It looks like a body, and then we have the strings here. We have four strings here, and these are the F holes, and this is the bridge. And then we have also found one fine tuner here on the tailpiece. And finally, we have the tune rest. Coming more closer to the violin, and what you can see here, let's go to the middle part of the violin. This is the most relevant part of a violin. The violin has four strings. It's the G, D, A and E. The chamber pitch is A, and we have with a tuning fork we can check the frequency, and if you put the tuning fork on the bridge you can hear the chamber pitch again. Here you hear the sound, and it means that the sound is coming from the fork to the bridge, and the bridge transforms the sound to the wood of the violin. Inside the violin there is a violin voice. It's named violin voice or soul of a violin. It's crucial. I cannot show it directly here. Maybe you can see this part inside the violin. This is the violin voice, and it's transforming the sound between the both parts of the violin, the spruce top and the maple back. Here the maple back is here, you see, and also inside here the waist, the C bouts, This looks like a sea, you see here on the other parts. And this is, the strings are swinging, using a bow, of course. And the swinging energy is going to the bridge. And then the top is swinging, and then the sounds goes through the voice of the violin in, to the back of the violin. That means the sounds goes from the upper part to the down part of the violin, and then it's reflecting out of these F holes. That means the sounds came out here. If I would cover the F holes, then the sound was suppressed somehow. Here I would like to summarize what I have explained to you before. Again, the violin is like a body. It has a head. The head contains a scroll, and there's a peg box, including the tuning pegs. And here's a neck and the fingerboard. It's here, from beginning here and here. And here, this specific part is the saddle, and the saddle fixes the violin string on a certain position for swinging. Here's the upper bout and the waist and the lower bout. And an interesting part of the violin is the inlay, which is shown here. The F-hole is also an important part of the violin. Interesting, the bridge has a weight of approximately 25 kilograms on the surface of the top of the violin. It's quite a lot. Here's a fine tuner. The also strings can also have fine tuners depending on the material of the violin strings. Here's a tailpiece. And finally, there's a chin rest. Another interesting point is, if you look through the F hole here inside the violin, you can see a printed violin label is showing here. If the upper part of the label is visible here, you can see the name of the violin maker. Here is Leon Bernardel. And if you look a bit lower part here, you can see the date and location. It was on 1923 and is made in Paris. Okay, I hope you enjoyed the introduction, and I gladly invite you to view another interesting presentation on this channel. Thank you for viewing this video.